Hey you guys, it's Christina and I'm so excited to share with you a very special interview today with one of my very close friends, joecross from Fat, Sick, and Nearly Dead. For those of you who do not know joecross, he is worldwide known for his incredible documentary, Fat, Sick, and Nearly Dead. He has changed the game when it's come to juicing and I'm so excited to have him on this video today. This past year, Joe and I co-hosted a retreat in Mallorca, Spain, and we sat down and we filmed this interview together. Now, I know I'm a little bit late in getting this up, but better late than never. And I want to preface this interview by letting you know that it is a little bit rough. I filmed it with my handheld, we sat down, it's very intimate, and we answered your questions. The questions that we answered in this video came from my inner circle members or my coaching group that I have. So these questions are intimate, they're personal, and we sit down and we answer them for you, or Joe really answers them for you, and he does such an amazing job. Inner circle members got first access to this video, and now I'm excited to share it with you. This video is a long one, so be sure to grab some fruit or some juice, some snacks, and for your convenience, I have all of the questions that we answer listed in the description of this video with time tags. So if you look in the description, you can click on it and it'll take you exactly to that point in this video where you can get your answer. I've also included the links where you can find Joe below in the description, and I definitely recommend you check his stuff out because he is just such a beautiful human and I feel honored and blessed just to know him. I didn't get to share that enough in the interview because we were so pressed for time, but I want to say that now before I show you this interview and to give you a heads up for how much love and respect I have for this beautiful human. I'm also excited because I know that this is just one of many to come from many collaborations between me and Joe, and I can't wait to have him back for more incredible interviews. If you haven't already, hit the subscribe button because there is more epicness to come. I cannot wait to share this amazing interview with you. So without further ado, ladies and gentlemen, I present to you my interview with joecross. It's Christina and I have a very special surprise for you today. Look who I am here with, joecross himself.
Hi guys, fantastic. Thank you Christina for inviting me onto your channel.
Absolutely.
To be here with you in beautiful Mallorca, Spain. The sun is shining, so awesome.
I'm thrilled that we're having the best time here in Mallorca, and just to be in Joe's presence is truly a gift. So,
ditto right back at you, Kate. She's amazing to hang around. I'm sure that those of you who've met Christina, you can't help but be inspired by her beauty, her love, her sharing, her kindness. You're amazing. So,
thanks, Joe.
Now that we've just said to each other how good each other are, we can wrap it up and go home.
Well, not quite. I asked the members of my inner circle program, those of you who've done your juice cleanses, who have become super inspired by Joe and by your own journey, to ask some questions to Joe, and you guys left some really, really great questions for me to ask him here. So I'm gonna go ahead and just start asking him and thank Joe for being willing to answer these. So
absolutely.
The first one comes from Carol Giambri. Hope I said that right. And he says, does Joe take supplements? What and during or after juicing?
So that's a great question, Carol. Thank you for asking that. So my journey, which has been mostly about trying to juice my way back to health, which I did in my movie Fat, Sick, and Nearly Dead. Back then in 2007, 2008, when I made that film, I didn't know much about anything. So when I did my long extended 60-day juice fast, I didn't take anything with it. I took no supplements, I added nothing. Now today, we've learned a lot. And if you're gonna juice fast for longer than 15 days, we really do sort of suggest it's not a bad idea to add some kind of a plant protein, a pea protein, or something to mix into your juices. We've had a bit of trouble, Christina, with a lot of, we've had some ladies have a bit of hair loss issues, and that's just been something that our medical advisory board has sort of said, well, after like 15 days, you probably need to add a little bit of protein for an extended long juice fast. Below 15 days, not necessary, but a long, long one, probably not a bad idea. Now, personally, on a daily basis with supplements, when I was living in Australia, I didn't need much vitamin D, but because I've been living up in the Northern Hemisphere a bit, I take a vitamin D, and I also take an omega-3 fatty acid. So they're the sort of two supplements that I take on a regular basis. Not every day, but you know, probably 9 months of the year, because there are some times where I just run out and I just forget to refill. So I'm not obsessed about it, but that's what I take.
Awesome. All right, so next question. I'm getting lost in my hair.
Yeah, we've got a bit of wind here.
We're getting lost in my Mufasa. All right, so next question is, what advice, this is from Katen Fee, what advice do you have for people who struggle living and staying plant-based? And by plant-based, I'm assuming she means vegan diet, primarily.
So, look, to me, I think that, you know, we are our greatest obstacles. We are the roadblocks in our own life. We sort of set up these roadblocks to fail. Now, everyone has their way of approaching this. Because we live in a world now with this technology, I'm a big believer, Christina, in actually talking to yourself. Now, I know they reckon that's the first sign of madness and going crazy, but you know when you're not feeling good, you know when you're not feeling happy, you know when you're feeling like pretty lousy, I think it's a great time to talk to yourself about how you're feeling so that you're saying, right, I'm gonna stay on plants, I'm gonna juice, I'm gonna go fully raw, I'm gonna, whatever it is that you're setting your goal on, I think it's awesome to be able to talk in and say, now Joe, the reason I'm doing this is because right now on this Friday, I feel lousy and I feel like this, la-da-da-da-da. And what you do is you actually talk to yourself so that later on, maybe in 3 or 4 days, maybe a week, maybe when you're just feeling, I want to crash, I want to stay off this, you know, I want to go get off this train, I want to do something else, I'm dying for a burger, whatever it is, you can pull out the video and listen, no one likes being told what to do by anybody, but when it's coming from within and when you can actually see yourself talking to yourself, I think that's really powerful. So that's one tip or one trick I would use. The other one I'm really big on is this visualization of what, when you put Mother Nature's best inside your body, just to visualize what is actually happening. And I kind of believe that we've all got this like military, if you like, inside. We've got our own Air Force, our own Navy, our own Marines. We've got this military. And what we need to do is we need to send supplies down the chain. We need to make sure that they can fight the best fight against the bad guys. And those bad guys is disease and illness and inflammation. So if you can think about supply chain, it's all about putting that micronutrient, beautiful food that's found in Mother Nature's finest, in our plants. And whether it's juicing, whether it's a smoothie, whether it's chewing, a beautiful salad, munching down an avocado, cracking open an apple, whatever it is, I visualize and think about how I'm resupplying my military forces to go out there and do battle and do good.
I love that. Never thought about going vegan as a...
Well, it's visualization, Christina. You see,
I love it.
I think you got to visualize this incredible, powerful effect that it has on your body.
It does have a powerful effect on your body.
Well, you're living proof of that. I mean, have a look at her. She's unbelievable. We were talking the other day about we don't get sick. I mean, Christina hasn't been sick for how many years?
Almost 13, really.
Yeah. Now, I'm not as strict, and I'm not like, you know, this is... I'm in the presence of greatness here right now, but I am somebody that I am fully raw probably about 3 months of the year in terms of my... I'm not that for the 12 months, so I'm like a quarter of it. But I don't get sick either, and I'm not even as extreme. And when I say I don't get sick, I mean, I think in 10 years, and I'll be very truthful, I think I've been maybe... We call it crook in Australia. I think I've been crook for maybe 4 or 5 days in 10 years. And you know,
wait,
food,
crook? What is crook?
Crook means like laid up. And I had food poisoning twice because, as you may know, when you eat a lot of raw produce, you're more susceptible to getting food poisoning depending on where the produce came from. And I also accidentally, while having a salad with some olive oil in Spain, actually in Barcelona 2 years ago, I inhaled some oil accidentally when I was eating. I had a hiccup, and the oil went down. I had to have some antibiotics for that. But apart from those times, I don't get sick. It just doesn't happen.
And that's why you're amazing. And you're teaching people how to do it. What you don't get to see is Joe behind the scenes is a power horse. He's always working. He's always making deals on his phone. He's just, he really is amazing and healthy. And we both got here and just even, he works through the jet lag, he works through everything, and so many people.
See, I think that Kay and I, we're both storytellers. That's what we do. We tell stories and we try. We're not experts. I don't know about you think, but I'm not an expert. I don't look at myself as an expert. What I do is I get to meet amazing people who are super smart, who know a lot, and I take what I can from them and sort of repackage it and share it in like normal words.
Right. And you're amazing at that.
Well, thank
by
you,
the way.
Christina. That's very
and he
nice.
Tells the best jokes. You've missed out on that. If you're not here, you've missed out on that.
Yeah, well, I need to develop some jokes about celery and carrots and so on. Yeah, I've got to get some of them going.
Next question comes from Anne O'Farrell. What are some of the best wisdom or insights for extended juice cleansing 30 plus days that he can offer?
Oh, 30 plus days. Okay, so. Well, first of all, we have to really try and understand what would be the motivation for somebody to go on a juice fast for an extended period of time. And in my experience with all the people that go beyond 30 days, that they're really addressing, they're trying to put some fire out. There's something that's really out of whack in their life. There's some crisis, okay? And for me, why I did 60, because I was, my body was just, you know, I was a walking time bomb. High cholesterol, high blood pressure. I had a chronic autoimmune disease. I was on 3 sets of pills per day, mornings, lunchtime, dinners. I was a walking mess. I was like, you know, probably a heart attack away from, you know, a pizza, one bite of a pizza away from a heart attack. I mean, I was in big trouble. So I needed to fight fire with fire. I needed to reintroduce myself to Mother Nature. I mean, I basically turned the back on Mother Nature when I was 17, 18, when I left home. And then for the next sort of 15 years, 16 years, I just like, you know, just ate processed food. And so in order to reintroduce myself to Mother Nature, in order to have her accept me and go back, you know, talk's cheap. I had to do it. It's all about action. So I had to take action. So I just went, boom, I'm going all in on juice. I did 60 days and then I did another 90 days of just eating fruits, vegetables, nuts, beans and seeds, all the good stuff. Now, the answer to the question for that motivation is that if you have got like something that is really affecting you, then use that as your power for going longer. In terms of, we talked about some protein over 15 days, we've talked about that, but in terms of some tips and advice, it gets easier. It gets easier as you get on. It's like a gear. You're in first gear, second gear, third gear. Once you get past 20 days, 21 days, 22 days, I feel like I'm in like fifth gear, Christina.
I know.
And then in like day 45, you find like sixth gear. And if I wasn't making a movie when I was on day 60, I would have stopped. So I think there's this mental challenge about finding your runway and getting into that zone where you are just cruising. Another thing, don't be too disappointed if your juicing actually minimizes. In other words, you might start out with 6 or 7 glasses a day and you might end up with 3 or 4 a day. And if you also wanted to throw some days of water in there, hey, if your body's sensing it and feeling it, go right ahead. So that's what I would do in terms of the practical, the mental. I go back to what I said earlier about the video. Why am I doing this? Why am I staying on this thing? If it's all about weight loss, much harder. I think it has to be focused on health, focused on release. Was that too long?
Actually, I was going to say the hardest time for people is usually the first 3 days. Dr. Carey explained a lot in depth scientific reasoning why the first 3 days are hardest for most people.
Yes.
But then after that, it's like a cruise and an elation.
Yeah, well, the first 3 days are so tough because your body's in an emergency. It's like so unnatural not to eat. For most of us, like chewing, that's what we do. And so when you're not chewing, all right, like the body's saying, hey, what's going on, Joe? Why aren't we eating? So it makes the body sort of has these protection modes of saying, well, we're going to make you feel lousy, we're going to make you feel tired, we're going to make you feel angry because you're not eating. So you've got to break through that 72-hour period, and then you're free.
So that actually is perfect for the next question. Comes from Roynetta, who asks, what do you do, speaking of chewing, when you feel so good on juicing that you don't want to eat a solid food?
Yeah, and I hear you.
And can you go on a juice fast every weekend or every few days a month? She wants to stay on this high.
Because she wants to stay high, yeah. I know what you're talking about with the high, because to me and all the hundreds of thousands of people that have followed into the paths of what Christina and I do in terms of our juicing experiences, you go from the basement to the penthouse. You go to the top of the mountain and you love the view because you've got this freedom, you've got this sense of smell, sense of eyesight, you've got this connection to Mother Nature. Your joints feel unbelievable. The inflammation's gone, no more fluid. You feel awesome. So how do you stay there? Well, you can eat the stuff you've been juicing, and you will stay there. Yes, eat the stuff you've been juicing and you will stay there. Because effectively, you've got a juicer in your stomach. I mean, your gut basically is a juicer. Your blender, there's the teeth, that's the blender. When you chew, you're blending. When it goes down into your gut, the vilia goes back and forth. It separates the nutrients, puts the fiber out through the bowel, which is kind of like what a juicer does. It like breaks down the fiber, takes the water. Inside the water is all these little enzymes and micronutrients, all the good stuff, tens of thousands of little chemicals that then go through the cell membrane of your gut, get packaged up, delivered in the bloodstream to all the billions of cells in your body. Everyone gets a feed, everybody's happy. So if you have been juicing, eat what you've been juicing and you'll stay on the high. Can you juice for like 2 or 3 days, eat 4 days? You can, but there are some issues with that. And predominantly what happens, and what you've got to be careful of, is that during those minimal 2-3 days of juicing, you can eat away at a bit of your muscle a little bit too much rather than your fat because you haven't been in the longer term enough. So I don't typically recommend cycling like that. I would suggest, if you wanted to, 1 day or 2 days and break it up with eating around it. So maybe you might want to juice on a Tuesday and then juice on a Friday. But doing like 3 days together and then 4 days eating and then 3 days together, 4 days eating, I'm not saying it's not good for you. I'm just saying that it's not something that I would say do that. I'd rather see you do like a Tuesday or a Friday juice and then eat the plants on the other days.
So hopefully could they do maybe 1 day a week? Because for a full year, I actually did every Tuesday for a whole year and it was amazing. And I did it because every Tuesday I had my busiest co-op day.
Yep.
I never sat down on a Tuesday. Yep. So for me to have juices was more efficient
Absolutely. And also I would even say, depending if you're on any medications and check with your medical provider, I would even say you could go a whole day with water on a Tuesday. You didn't need to have the juice. But if you're active life and you need to move, then you could. But hey, I mean, I do water fasting quite a lot. In fact, probably the last year, because I've been experimenting, I've been doing more sort of water fasting than I have been doing juice fasting. I have been drinking lots of juice when the days that I am eating, but I've done more water fasting lately than juice fasting, just to mix it up, just to see what's going on, just to experiment, just to be the human guinea pig.
And it's quite powerful, isn't it?
Beyond powerful. Beyond powerful. You gotta be careful. I don't like sort of running out in the world and telling everybody, hey, go do water fasting, because there are some issues you gotta just be conscious and careful about. But if you're in a good state, if you have a good diet, if you're healthy and strong, it's a great thing to do. But some people who are not, some people who are sick, some people who are eating a standard American diet, if they water fast, it can actually be negative effects. So that's why it's not like one glove fits all. But with juicing, I actually believe that for juicing, if you add juicing into your day every day, if you add beautiful plants, food, fruits, vegetables, nuts, beans, seeds. Some people like the whole grains. I think that most people, Christina, most people will benefit from that.
I agree. And you're an example. So next question comes from Kayleen Peters, and she says, any special advice for folks avoiding type 2 diabetes, kidney troubles, or even cancer?
You mean avoiding those diseases? So they are trying to avoid those diseases, or are we talking about people who have those illnesses and want to juice?
She just said avoiding. So, I mean,
so if you're trying to avoid those illnesses, right? So, I mean, here's how I look at it, Christina. Okay? You cannot ignore the biological laws of cause and effect. That's as simple as that. Our system, the way that we consume our nutrients, and let's just make sure we understand nutrients are everything. You go to the local fast food restaurant and you get like a highly processed burger, that's actually what we call nutrients. Now, it's not the nutrients that we necessarily think are going to be helpful to your body, but they are nutrients, and these are the building blocks. You've got the big macros, which are your protein, your carbohydrate, and your fat. And then you've got the micros, which are the vitamins, the minerals, or the phytochemicals, all of these things that really we've only just started to discover in the last 100 years, and we're discovering new phytochemicals every week. So the problem we have is that everyone is consuming fat and carbohydrate and protein, because we can get that in processed food, we can get that in animal product. But where this magic lies, which I call the information for ourselves to function properly, well, that lives in all the plant food, in the fruits, vegetables, nuts, beans, seeds, and whole grains. So,
all right, so let's see, a few others for you right here.
Yep, so we've got bees all around us here. We're in a beautiful garden here. Like, if we swing around and look, you can see this beautiful garden where we're sitting. It's just awesome. But where there is garden and flowers, there are bees.
Lorraine just wanted to comment and said, "This is amazing. I'm loving this lifestyle, loving all the incredible, inspirational people that I'm surrounded by, especially you, Joe." Just wanted to say that.
Thank you, Lorraine.
Any advice? This is from Fallon, who said, "Any advice for people who are trying to heal gut issues, osteoporosis, underactive thyroid? How to support the body through detox? Would everything you just said apply to that as well?"
Absolutely, and more. Okay. Because your gut microbiome really changes. I mean, look, let me just say this before we say anything about it. We are just at the very beginning of learning about this gut microbiome. This is so early in the piece. So a lot of the smarter scientists are going to be very careful about talking about this and saying things, because we just don't have the information yet to be able to come out. But things we do know, and things that we are pretty confident about, is that we have more cells in our body that are from microbes that are non-human than human cells. So we are mostly microbes, and these microbes, most of them are pretty good for us, and we need them, and they're part of us functioning, and we just can't live without them. And so this microbiome, like when we travel, like I flew from New York, you flew from Houston, mm-hmm. and we're now in Spain, because we're in this different environment, our microbiome's changed just from where we are. I read recently and heard a great doctor, and he's blanking on his name right now, but he was telling me, or via the article and I'm listening on a podcast, is that hanging out near ferns, like if you see a fern, go and sit next to a fern for 10 minutes and breathe in all the air around a fern, because that can help your microbiome. And then of course, the big thing that affects your microbiome, apart from sleep, apart from working out, apart from having fun and laughing, is the food that you put in your body. And it constantly changes. And so without a question, your gut. Now, a lot of people have a thing called leaky gut, which is the membrane is so inflamed that little holes. And then when you eat the food and the nutrients and going through the bowel, you leak, you get out into the system, and this isn't good because this causes inflammation. Now, I think, to be honest, when back in the day when I was sick, I reckon I had a bit of this, although I was never diagnosed. And through 60 days of juicing, through 90 days of eating plants, I believe I gave my body a chance to heal itself so that those little holes closed up. And then, of course, my autoimmune disease went away. So we've seen lots of people with diabetes type 2 do reboots, adapt the lifestyle that Christina is living, and diabetes go away. I mean, her diabetes gone with a fully raw diet lifestyle. So it doesn't just need to be juicing. It doesn't need to be just this. It's just about consuming a lot more plants. And I know people that are not fully raw, they're not fully vegan, and you can still do this. So if you're out there and you're not in that lifestyle, don't despair. Don't think, oh my God, I've got to do this or I'm doomed. That's not true. Just by pumping up, doubling your volume or tripling your volume of fruits and veggies can have phenomenal effects. Phenomenal.
I love it. So I have the same question from two people, one from Jordan and Veronica, both saying, how do you juice on road trips, especially when you're going out of state? Which I think this is perfect because you went to a whole different country to juice.
Yeah.
So, I mean.
So first of all, today's world, it's not that difficult because there are so many local mum and pop shops and, you know, just college kids that are juicing and making deliveries from their kitchens. So you can go online, you can find these people, they're out there. Go on Instagram, look for juicing in your area, use location. So I don't travel with a juicer much anymore because there are so many people out there that are juicing that I wanna feel the love. I wanna get the love from them.
I know. Can I add something in there? personally, I mean, you guys know I travel a lot. It's actually easier for me to find juice now than it is to find raw food prepared.
Yeah, it would be.
Hands down. So,
No,
I just
it would
wanted
be.
To say that.
And so, like, even on airplanes now, I've been on flights where I've been given green juice. Can you believe that? Like, they have fresh green juice on some airplane flights. That's down from Australia up to the US. I flew the other day on Qantas, and I was given green juice. I mean, wow, right? So, but back in the day, it was harder. I totally agree. The hardest thing I had during my making of the movie was cleaning the juicer, because making the juice, because you buy the produce, you have a generator, you pull over the side of the road, but now cleaning it, because you go into the gas stations, or the petrol stations as we call them in Australia, and you try to clean the juicer, those little sinks in those toilets, you can't get everything underneath. So quite often what we would do is we would go and knock on the door of someone and say, hey, can we use your hose in your front yard or your tap and use it? And they were very funny, and some people, I mean, most people said yes. Sometimes the people weren't home, and so we just went to a, you know, I think maybe we might have even used it when they weren't home, but that was because we were desperate.
Can I use your hose?
But generally, yeah. Can I have your hose? I need your hose. And some people said, what do you mean? What are you talking about? No, I need hose. Hose.
I need to clean my juicer.
Yeah, hose. You can understand with my accent, some people get the wrong idea what that is.
Oh my God. Joe's really funny. He's even more funny in real life. All right, so we're nearing the end of the questions. Thank you, Joe. Sometimes
okay.
I do that, it's okay.
It's all right.
This one comes from Corey McGraw. She said, my question is, how do you deal with temptation during a juice cleanse?
Yeah, this is the tough one. I mean, like,
So best for last, maybe?
Yeah, but it's very tough, and I understand it, because generally speaking, what I have found, Christina, is that the food that you are missing the most is the food that's doing you the most harm. And what I mean by that is it changes. The longer you go, the more you start dreaming about avocados, and as you're making the juice, all you want to do is just like eat the celery and chew. But in the beginning, you know, like, what are you missing? And you know, for me it was Coca-Cola. Like, I was just missing my Coke. I was missing my burgers. I was missing that, you know, going into a McDonald's and having two Big Macs, two cheeseburgers, large fries, chocolate shake, sundae, apple pie, and a Diet Coke.
You may be making them hungry if they're fasting right now.
No, but that's what I would consume. So I missed that, filling that hole up with all that sugar, fat, and salt. And that was what I was missing. So I kind of realized that that's kind of the nemesis. So, you know, it's 11 years now. I've had none of that in 11 years. I just like shut the door on that. And so to me now, as I'm into them, I don't have as much problems now with the temptation. I did, but I don't so now, because I think I blocked a lot of the temptation ones out of my life when I'm actually eating, let alone when I'm juicing. And that's just a momentum thing of a habit. So I'd say that. I'd also go back to what I said earlier about that, pulling that little video out as to why you're on this path and why you're doing it. What's the purpose? What's the reason? You know, life is this incredible gift that we're all given. I mean, anyone watching this now is alive by definition, right? And so we all have this incredible, beautiful gift. And when I'm juicing and all my friends are out at a party or doing something, I kind of think, well, the 5 days or 10 days or 15 days that I'm doing now, I am getting days in the bank. Like, it's kind of adding 30 or 40 or 50 or 100 days to my life. That's how I think. I think that what I'm going through now, this nourishment, this pouring in, this abundance of micronutrients, like flooding my system, that I'm kind of buying time, if you like. Yes, I'm losing and missing out today, and I'm missing out maybe on that meal, but it enables me to live longer and happier and maybe have maybe five of those meals at certain stages of my life in the future. So I kind of really use that power that while it might seem that I'm missing out now, I'm actually gaining. And so I don't know, hopefully that makes sense.
It's longevity. You're gaining longevity.
Yeah.
Your quality of life is increasing as you're doing this, which is amazing.
Absolutely.
So I want to thank you first, Joe, for doing this with me. Thank you so much.
It's so great to be here. And thank you so much, Christina, for coming and sharing these wonderful days here in Calreit in Spain. I mean, it's been awesome.
I can't wait to do it again.
It's been awesome. You're awesome. Everyone loves Christina. Everyone. Everyone who meets her, they go, oh my God, she's so amazing. So amazing. And she just glows. There's just energy around her. You don't even need to talk to Christina. Just be in her presence and you get it.
Thank you, Joe. And I want to thank you all for being a part of this with us and for being on this journey with us, for your questions, your support, your love. Joe and I couldn't do it without you. We're so grateful. And yeah, we will see you soon, maybe on one of our future retreats together.
Absolutely.
I'll put links below so you guys can go check out Joe. You can find his channel. Joe the Juicer is his Instagram. Any other information, I'll put in the links below so you guys can check him out there.
And can we do a juice on to say goodbye?
Yeah.
Together?
You want to do...
A sign out with a juice on?
Sure.
I know you sign out a different way, right?
Oh, no, let's do it. Okay, okay. Ready?
Are you ready? All right.
1, 2, 3.
Juice on! You got to come in. Like, hold on, we're going to get this right. Okay? Are you ready?
Oh,
are you ready?
Yeah, I'm ready.
Okay, all right.
1, 2, 3.
Juice on!
All right, you guys, I hope that you have enjoyed this awesome interview. If you have, please don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and to go give Joe a follow. All the links of where you can find him are in the description below. And if you've liked this video and if you'd like more, don't forget to hit the subscribe button. I cannot wait to see you all in my next video. Show Joe some love in the comments below. We can't wait to read them, and I'll see you all in my next video. Thank you all so much. Sending you all my hugs and my love.